William Henry Johnson, commonly known as Henry Johnson, was a United States Army soldier who fought during World War I. Johnson enlisted in the United States military on June 5, 1917, joining the all-black New York National Guard 15th Infantry Regiment, which was later redesignated as the 369th Infantry Regiment, based out of Harlem. Although the General of the Armies, John J. Pershing, the highest ranking officer in the United States Army, wished to keep the U.S. Army autonomous during the First Great War, he graciously loaned the 369th to the 161st Division of the French Army. He was eagerly willing to detach the Afro-American regiments from U.S. command because the majority of white U.S. soldiers refused to fight alongside black troops. The French army had no such problem and were happy to accept the needed reinforcements. One of the first regiments to arrive in France, as well as one of the most highly decorated upon return, was the 369th Infantry, which later became known as the famous Harlem Hellfighters. The 369th got off to a rocky departure from the United States. Their transport, which had stopped and anchored because of a sudden snowstorm, was struck by another ship due to poor visibility. The captain of their transport, the Pocahontas, wished to turn back, but the members of the 369th repaired the damage themselves, and the ship sailed on, battered but undaunted. The French army would go on to assign Johnson's regiment to Outpost 20 on the edge of the Argonne Forest in the Champagne region of France, equipping them with French rifles and helmets, a U.S. regiment, due to color, forced to fight under the French flag. While on observation post duty on the night of May 14, 1918, Private Johnson came under attack by a large German raiding party, which may have numbered as many as 24 German soldiers. Johnson displayed uncommon heroism by using grenades, the butt of his rifle, a bolo knife, and ultimately his bare fist to fend off the Germans, thereby rescuing Needham Roberts from capture and saving the lives of his fellow soldiers. Johnson accomplished this heroic feat all the while suffering 21 total wounds. This act of valor earned him the nickname of Black Death as a sign of respect for his prowess in combat. The story of Johnson's exploits first came to national attention in an article by Irvin S. Cobb entitled Young Black Joe, which was published in August of 1918 in the Saturday Evening Post. Recognition for Johnson would not extend into the U.S. military, since in 1918, racism against African Americans was common among white U.S. soldiers, but French attitudes differed. Johnson, an American soldier, was recognized by the French Army with a war cross with a star and bronze palm, and was the first U.S. soldier, black or white, to receive that honor during World War I. Returning home, now Sergeant Johnson participated in a victory parade with his regiment down Fifth Avenue in New York City in February of 1919. Sergeant Johnson was then paid to take part in a series of lecture tours across the nation. He appeared one evening in St. Louis, and instead of delivering the expected tale of racial harmony in the trenches, he instead revealed the truth about the abuse which black soldiers had suffered. Soon after this, a warrant was issued for Johnson's arrest for wearing his uniform beyond the prescribed date of his commission, a manufactured allegation that caused Johnson's paid lecturing engagements to dry up. Johnson would die a decade later, poor and in obscurity. And from 1919 on, Henry Johnson's story has been a part of wider investigation into the treatment of African Americans during the Great War. Unfortunately, after his death, there ensued a long struggle to achieve awards for Johnson from the U.S. military. He was finally awarded the Purple Heart in 1996, 67 years after his death. In 2002, the U.S. military awarded him the Distinguished Service Cross. Previous efforts to secure the well-deserved Medal of Honor had failed. However, on June 2, 2015, he was finally awarded the Medal of Honor in a ceremony at the White House held by President Barack Obama. We salute you, Sergeant Henry Johnson. You fearlessly fought not only for your brothers, but for a country that was never willing to fight for you. And now, it is up to us to fight to keep the memory of your heroism and leadership alive.